triumph is the victory alone. Hark the songs of peaceful Zion, thunder like a mighty flood. Jesus out of every nation has redeemed us by his blood. Alleluia, not as orphans are we left in sorrow now. Alleluia, he is near us, faith believes, nor questions how. Though the cloud from sight received him, when the 40 days were o'er, shall our hearts forget his promise, I am with you evermore.
Morning, and thank you for joining us in prayer. We gather together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As our Easter journey continues, we recognize that in new ways, God longs to break into the routines of our life, to past hurts, to suffering, and to give us new hope. Aware that we need to let him in and be willing to forgive, we call to mind our own sins.
Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gloria, Gloria, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Gloria, Gloria, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people.
Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went down to the city of Samaria and proclaimed the Christ to them. With one accord, the crowds paid attention to what was said by Philip when they heard it and saw the signs he was doing. For unclean spirits, crying out in a loud voice, came out of many possessed people, and many paralyzed or crippled people were cured. There was great joy in that city. Now when the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent them Peter and John, who went down and prayed for them, that they might receive the Holy Spirit, for it had not yet fallen upon any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. They laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Shout joyfully to God, all the earth. Sing praise to the glory of his name. Proclaim his glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous are your deeds. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Let all on earth worship and sing praise to you. Sing praise to your name. Come and see the works of God, his tremendous deeds among the children of Adam. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. He has changed the sea into dry land. Through the river they passed on foot. Therefore, let us rejoice in him. His rules by his might forever. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Hear now, all you who fear God, while I declare what he has done for me. Blessed be God who refused me not my prayer or his kindness. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, sanctify Christ as Lord in your hearts. Always be ready to give an explanation to anyone who asks you for a reason for your hope, but do it with gentleness and reverence, keeping your conscience clear, so that when you are maligned, those who defame your good conduct in Christ may themselves be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if that be the will of God, than for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh He was brought to life in the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot accept, because it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he remains with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. In a little while the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and I will be with you in your life. And on that day you will realize that I am in my Father, you are in me, and I in you. Whoever has my commandments and observes them is the one who loves me. And whoever loves me will be loved by the Father. And I will love him and reveal myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We hear mention of Samaria in our second reading, our New Testament reading from St. Peter today. Comes to us from other stories in the Gospel. It's hard for us, so many years removed, to get our minds and hearts around what was the situation like there. And maybe a current example could be helpful. You know, the great pains and divisions that Ireland had faced, right, Northern Ireland, and during the Troubles. Catholics and Protestants, from the outside you would say, but aren't they Christians? Aren't they on the same island? How come there's so much pain and division? Similarly, so the tribes of Jacob split, right? The northern kingdom and Judah. And then concessions begin to be made, right? With Assyria, or later during the exile with Babylon, and intermarrying and judgments of each other for that, and changes in worship starts to create a real bitter division between the Samaritans and the Jews. It was so painful that they could no longer see the good in each other, though they had those original roots together. That's what provides the great punch of the parable of the Good Samaritan, or the shock of the apostles when they find Jesus interacting with the woman at the well, the Samaritan. Could you imagine a unionist caring for the nationalist after two countrymen had passed by on the other side? Right? That would have been shocking in Northern Ireland. Or a nationalist asking a unionist for a drink. Well, it's Ireland. Maybe that one's easier to imagine. All right. But the conflict between the Jews and the Samaritans was religious and political, and it was deep. And into that world steps Philip in this great Acts of the Apostles moment, right? Like he's ready to reach out to a group that didn't normally accept the Jewish preachers. So his success is rather shocking, right? Well, it rested not
on his taking one side or another in this long historical, political, painful, social debate. Both were loaded with baggage from the past. Rather, he was successful by speaking of a future in Christ. See that? He moves from the past and the pain and division to a future in Christ. And what does he speak of? He speaks of what Jesus himself is willing to let us know is going to happen. That there's going to be pain and suffering. We are not made for here. We will suffer. We will fail. Our failure will hurt others and cause them suffering. The pain will be real. And what does suffering do? Suffering stirs cynicism. Right? Suffering stirs cynicism. It can also stir a seeking, but it can stir a cynicism. And so Peter addresses that head on. Three times in the letter he mentions suffering. Jesus is not here now, right? When Peter's writing, he's ascended. But Jesus is not here now. Here, this world is not the end. We are made for the end, not for here. We are made for where Jesus is. But while we are still here, we will suffer. So it's almost a matter of factness about the way Peter addresses suffering. Like, this is going to happen. It's part of life in this world. Rather than try to pretend, oh no, there's no place for suffering in this world, he says, it is. There is. That's what this world is. It's going to be a place of suffering. We don't always want to hear that. We want to try to run from suffering and find cures as best we can. There's a little series on Netflix called The Pharmacist. And it's a good kind of documentary look through the last 20, 25 years, 30 years even, of the opioid kind of crisis, abuse crisis in our country. What led to the request of so many prescriptions that flooded the market? It was the claim of this wonder drug that it would end suffering, right? That's the attractiveness. That's what the people were running for. But what? I can get through life without pain, without suffering? Sign me up. And so the prescriptions are written for the people looking to end suffering. Well, as it spun out in these last 20, 25, 30 years, ask anyone who has struggled with addiction or watched a family member struggle with addiction, maybe even lost a loved one to that addiction. It doesn't end suffering. It multiplies it. That's important for us to realize that there's no wonder drug in this world that is going to end suffering. This is a world in which we will have pain. We will have suffering. Jesus isn't oxy. All right? He doesn't promise to take away pain and suffering. He offers to transform it. He offers to be with you through it. He offers to send you a spirit to accompany you and to strengthen you in your suffering so that you are not alone. Jesus is wonderful in his prayer in the garden. What does he do? It's his moment of great suffering, knowing what's coming. He invites others into it. Right? Peter, James, and John, come with me and pray with me for a while. He doesn't sit alone in his suffering. He invites others into it. He turns to God. Talks about the pain and the suffering, and what is God's great gift back to him is the ministering angels, right? Like to bring him a peace that, yes, you are going to go through this way of the cross and the suffering, but it will not end there. There's a future. There's something so important about that. Jesus then, because he's been down that path, is able to say to us, I know it seems like too much. I know the suffering you are facing is overwhelming you. I know it hurts. It hurts me too. I'm with you. Let us cry out together to the Father to send the Spirit, to send ministering angels. Jesus joins us in our prayer and draws us out of ourselves. He lifts our eyes to a horizon further than we can see on our own. Pain shortens our vision, right? Kind of turns us to navel gazing, looking inward, feeling how awful this is, how trapped I am. I'll never get out of this. We struggle to see past the moment in front of us. past the momentariness of this life, it's passing, we forget who we are. And we need to be reminded. Right? Forget who we are. That why isn't it going so perfect here? Oh yeah, remember what Peter says. This is passing. We're made for something further down the line. A future full of hope, right? That's something that Jeremiah gave us in the Old Testament. Be always ready to speak to that hope. Why do you live so differently? Philip, you show up in town, and rather than further the divide, you're bringing a union in a place that has never known it before. Why? You lifted our eyes further down the line. We're made for something bigger than our past divisions and our changes in political alliances and worship. So the Samaritans have these great conversions, and the Jewish leaders come down and say, wow, look what's new here. Jesus, the way. And what do? They pray for the promised Holy Spirit to preserve that unity, that it wouldn't fade away again. That's what we need in our lives. When the pain and the suffering has us looking like it'll never change, it'll never be any different from now, we need the gift of that Holy Spirit. So Jesus prays with us and promises to send it, that the Father would give us this Spirit, who will lift our eyes beyond the horizons of revenge and hatred, past power and control, to who we really are, to what we are really made for, to the end for which we are made, that which gives us a reason to hope. I invite you to stand together as we profess our faith.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation,
he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With confidence in a God who longs to reach into our world to alleviate our suffering, we lift our prayer and petition this day.
For safety and good health as communities reopen, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a full outpouring of the Holy Spirit and the Church, and for our students awaiting confirmation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders in business and politics, that the Holy Spirit may guide their decisions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For seminarians preparing for ordination, that they may wait with joyful expectation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And that the suffering may not feel alone, but may feel the company of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Richard Capone, Wilson Tenney, Salvatore Lanera, and for Ann Bitterman, whom we remember in a special way in today's Mass. And for the recently deceased in St. Elizabeth Ann Seton and in our families, and for all who have died, may they enjoy eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and loving Father, we lift to you these many needs we have spoken, the needs we carry still in our hearts, and the needs we don't yet realize. We ask you to hear and answer each one of them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
I invite you to stand together and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Elizabeth Ann Seton, Saint Mary Ann Cope, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Douglas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
If you love me, keep my commandments, says the Lord, and I will ask the Father, and he will send you another Paraclete to abide with you forever. Hallelujah.
The body of
Christ.
Thank you.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a couple notes today. The obviously, opening up has got people asking questions about, you know, churches be open soon, what will worship look like? Bishop Lucia addresses that. Check it out on the diocese website or YouTube or Facebook pages. But the quick answer is not yet phase one, but it is being discussed and processed, what will worship look like. So keep praying for wisdom and the right timing for that to roll out. And if you want to see the bishop's words, check it out down on the websites. Second would be Thursday, Ascension Thursday, a holy day of obligation in New York. Obviously, under these conditions, people can't get to Mass, but I do want to remind you, encourage you to still attend Mass as you can. We'll be at 9, we'll be recording live, but if you need to watch it later in the day to tune in, or to find another feed if you need it earlier in the day. But please, let's make sure we honor and celebrate in a special way this Thursday, Ascension Thursday. There's more on our website, as a bulletin is posted each week, so you can always keep up with the events going on here. So thanks for tuning in with us today and staying connected in prayer. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. This Mass is ended. Let us go in joy and in peace to serve our God and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in our novena prayer.
O Mary, full of grace, patroness of this nation and mother of the Church, in this time of illness and worldwide need, we seek your intercession for the human family before your Son's throne of grace and mercy. We ask for strength in adversity,
health in weakness,
and comfort in sorrow. Help us, O Blessed Mother, to be filled with confidence and trust in the tender compassion of our God. Let us not be afraid, like our own Saint Mary Anko, who entrusted her life and ministry among the outcasts of society into the care of our divine physician. Continue to watch over all who are sick, as well as those who care for them, and give wisdom to all who are seeking a cure. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.